Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Microbes in Human Welfare. In that we are studying about vitamins. Now when I say about vitamins, all of us in our childhood would have eaten vitamins, tablets. Yes, I am talking about vitamin A, D, E, K, all those vitamin tablets which doctor gives you when you are ill. So these vitamin tablets must be made in certain process. Today we'll be studying how these vitamin tablets are basically made in industries. Hello students, we are studying chapter Microbes in Human Welfare. In that we are studying vitamins. When I say about vitamins, we all must be thinking about all the vitamin tablets which we ate in our childhood. When we were ill, doctor gave us vitamin tablets. Yes, vitamin A, D, E, K, all those vitamin tablets. Even different supplements like Bonvita, all the supplements have vitamin tablets. Today we'll be studying how these vitamin tablets or vitamins are made. So basically, all these vitamin tablets are made with the help of microorganisms, or some could be made with the help of plants, except vitamin D or calciferol, that is made by the help of animal source. All these vitamin tablets are made by using microorganisms into a fermenter. Now when I say fermenter, it is nothing but a steel chamber which has various inlet devices, an oxygen chamber, a processing unit, as well as a stirrer. In the production of vitamin, the fermenter which is used is nothing but stir tank fermenter. When I say stir tank fermenter, it means a fermenter which you can add the raw materials and you can continuously stir it. When you stir in the fermenter, the raw materials are mixed precisely, very carefully, as well as the mixing of oxygen, and all the organisms are in proper and proportionate manner. So for the production of vitamins, the three major things.
Okay. So वीडियो में ऐसा मत दिखाएगा कि मैं देख के बता दे।
ठीक है चलेगा।
सर है ना? तो देखना होगा तो थोड़ा साइड में आके दो मिनट देखिए, आके फिर स्टार्ट कर दे।
चलो।
स्टार्ट।
ओके। Let us talk about how vitamin B12 is synthesized. For the production of vitamin B12, the three things which are important is one, fermenter; second, microorganism; and third, the raw material. The fermenter which is used is stir tank fermenter. The organism that is used is Pseudomonas methugens, and the raw material that is used is various microbial source. So let us see study about vitamins. Vitamins, yes, the medicines or the tablets which we all have eaten. Vitamins are synthesized by microbes and green photosynthetic plants, except vitamin D, which is synthesized by animal source. So all the vitamins, whether it is vitamin A, B, E, K, all of them are synthesized by microbes or plant source. But vitamin D is synthesized with the help of an animal source. Second thing. First vitamin produced by fermenters, which was stir tank fermenter, was vitamin C. Yes, the vitamin that is found in lemon and oranges, the citrus vitamin, the vitamin which is water soluble, was developed by Alexander Van. Let us see how vitamins are made and what are the materials that are required to make vitamins. For the production of vitamins, the materials that are required are fermenters. The fermenter that is used is stir tank fermenter. In stir tank fermenters, you can continuously shake or agitate the raw material, oxygen, as well as microbes, which enhance the mixing. Second, the microbes that are widely used are microorganisms like Pseudomonas, Streptomyces, Olivis are widely used for vitamin productions, whether it is fat soluble or water soluble. Vitamins are of two types, that is fat soluble. When I say fat soluble, you need to eat it and body in body it gets stored. Fat soluble vitamins are not released continuously. Your body stores them. Examples are vitamin A, D, E, and K. So we were talking about fat soluble vitamins, how body stores fat soluble vitamins and utilize them later. So it is not necessary to take all the fat soluble vitamins regularly. For example, vitamin E can be taken in certain amount of time or certain amount of period. Next are vitamins which are water soluble, like B complex and vitamin C. Now this water soluble vitamins are removed out of body and they need not be taken regularly. It means you have to take them regularly. Vitamin B complex and vitamin C. Vitamin C in lemons as well as vitamin B complex in fruits and vegetables are continuously removed out of body. So you have to take them regularly. I hope that we have gone through all the vitamins, how they are made, what is their function, and we have understood each and everything. Thank you.